Welcome back, guys, to another episode of AppSticky. Today we are going to take a look at the GTX 980 and its benchmarks. As usual, we are going to benchmark the Asus Strix edition of the GTX 980, which comes with a $570 price tag. It is a 4GB video card and doesn't have the video memory issue the GTX 970 had. Asus has 3 models for the GTX 980. The other 2 models is going to cost you much more. Like the other cards of the Asus Strix series, this card also comes with geodesical fan technology, which allows for complete silent operation mode as the fan is turned off until the card reaches a certain temperature. So you can play games like League of Legends and StarCraft in complete silence as the fan doesn't need to move at all. The 980 replaces the GTX 780 with much less power consumption and less heat. Now let's take a look at the specifications of the reference GTX 980 and 780 and make a comparison. We can see that the GTX 980 reference model has a much higher base clock, boost clock and higher memory speed with more render output units compared to the GTX 780 reference model. The GTX 980 also has a 4GB video memory while the GTX 780 had 3GB. But the GTX 780 has a higher memory bus, CUDA cores and texture units. The Asus card comes overclocked out of the box with more base clock and boost clock speed than the reference model. Now as we got the specifications out of the way, now let's see how the GTX 980 really performs. If you want to know more about the Asus Strix card, I'll leave a link in the description. I don't think the GTX 980 is a 1080p card, as even its smaller brother the GTX 970 is a game killer at 1080p. So we will do the benchmarks in 1440p, also we'll take a look at how the card performs in 4K. It's time to go to the benchmarks we all are waiting for, here we go. As you see that at 1440p, the GTX 980 performs much better than the GTX 780 and also beats AMD's R9290x. But the GTX 780 Ti is a great competitor and performs even better in some games. But overall, the GTX 980 was the replacement of the GTX 780. So it did what it was made to do, right? Perform better than the GTX 780 with, I guess, much less power consumption and less heat. Also delivered some great gaming performance at 4K as you saw there. But if you ask me what I think about it, well, I would definitely say I expected a bit more out of it. So what do you think? The GTX 980 performed to your expectations or you wanted more? Let me know in the comments down below. If you like the video, then don't forget to hit that like button. Also, if it's your first time to my channel, then I would like you to subscribe for regular tech videos and updates that we do every week. And hopefully I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.